Similar to an organ. So the second piece, we're moving from probably the greatest composer who ever lived, a musical genius. So I want you to eliminate that from your memory bank for a moment. No comparisons, please. This is a piece I wrote in 2009 in our second trip to North Dakota. There is a music camp in North Dakota. It is on the border of North Dakota and Manitoba. It's called the International Music Camp. And we've been going now for 13 years. We were not able to go either last year or this year because of COVID. So when I was up there the second year, I started writing this piece. There are three movements. The first movement is about Theodore Roosevelt National Park, which is on the west side of the state. Very badlands looking type of place, if you've ever seen pictures of that. Lots of bison, lots of smaller animals. Very rugged, not a well-traveled or populated, I should say, national park. One of those that you go to hike and backpack and be away from lots of people. Try to capture the grandeur of it. It's very large and very glorious vistas. The second movement is about the Peace Garden itself. The Peace Garden is actually a strip of land where you've passed customs on the American side or the Canadian side, but before you reach customs in the other country, you turn into this shared land. So you can actually, as I did many times there, you can go for a run from one country to the other and back. There's nothing to stop you. When you leave, you always have to go through customs in either country. So this is sunrise at the Peace Garden, and there used to be, up to 4 years ago, a huge peace tower. Unfortunately, some of the cement started to break off, so they had to tear it down. But it formed two V's, and in the center of them was the line between the two countries, and the sun would rise right behind it so you could see it. And then the last movement, probably the most humorous of them, on the range. When we were coming back from the Theodore Roosevelt National Park, we were driving down I-94 east, you can see probably 100 miles. And way off in the distance, I thought I saw a giant cow. And of course, at some point you're thinking, uh-oh, this is not good. I'm starting to hallucinate. But as we get closer, you start to get closer and closer, you see, and it's actually, the name is Salem Sioux. And Salem Sioux is a 50-foot long, 40-foot high Holstein cow that was put up near I-94 on a hill, which makes it even larger looking, to celebrate the dairy industry and the cattle industry in North Dakota. So when I was writing this, I wanted to make it a little more humorous. So you'll notice that the giddy up of the horse kind of has a little bit of a limp, and you'll notice that in the piece. And then in the end of this movement, you'll notice the first movement coming back to tie it together. So this is three movements, Dakota Sounds.
Thank you.
I don't know where he is, but one more round of applause for Dean Zuger. What a great piece. It's the joy of doing part of your concert, you know, in video. It's like, we're all rested up and ready to go. I'm Tony Zielinczyk. I'm the tuba professor here at Capital University. Thank you for joining us, those of you here in the audience and those of you online. Again, that was Dakota Sounds by Tom Zuger. Great piece. The next piece we're going to do is by composer Alice Gomez. Alice is a Texas-based composer. She has been composer in residence for the San Antonio Symphony, for the Midland Odessa Symphony, many other groups, cultural centers in Texas. Her mission as a composer is to bring forward musical styles from her own Latin American traditions through African, Native American, and just trying to bring all these things together into her concert world. She's currently working on an adaptation of The Nutcracker, and Carmen with different cultural influences. This piece is called Huapango. Huapango is a series of different Mexican styles, and the word actually derives from an older word which means on top of the wood. Dancers who danced in this dance would dance on top of a wooden platform. The characteristic rhythm that you're going to hear in the Huapango is the Himiola rhythm, where you're going to hear the higher instruments playing 6/8, and the bass will be bom, 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 bom. So you'll hear a definite Himiola rhythm going on through this. Again, another opportunity that Dr. Gomez has given us to explore some music from different cultures in a very modern idiom. So hopefully you will enjoy this. This is Alice Gomez's Huapango. Thank you. Thank you, but it's nice to play in front of a live audience. I can't remember the last time I've done that. It's great to have people both here and live streaming, hearing live music again. And one more step on our way back to whatever our new normal will be. That first piece is by Jocelyn Hagen. Jocelyn went to St. Olaf College in Minnesota. She's from originally Valley City, North Dakota. And she did her master's degree in composition at the University of Minnesota. Her output of compositions is mostly in the choral area, solo voice, choir, chamber music and voice. But she did write this one brass quintet. And I met Jocelyn in 2009 at the International Music Camp. She was the composer in residence there. The piece is actually, as you see, five movements. That is the last movement. The third movement is a tuba soliloquy. The piece was set to be premiered in 2010, but it did not happen. So I'm not sure if the piece has been premiered at this point in its entirety. It is about 19 minutes total. So we did just the last movement today. The next piece by Fats Waller, a great stride piano player, the Harlem stride piano style, which is the forerunner of what we consider the modern jazz pianist. He composed over 400 songs, and three of them were selected to be in the Grammy Hall of Fame, including this one, Ain't Misbehavin'. And he did that in an incredibly, sadly, short life of only 39 years. He was in the process of writing a Broadway musical when he passed away from pneumonia on a train ride from New York to Los Angeles. Interesting little fact about Fats Waller: when he was in his 20s, in the Roaring Twenties, he was kidnapped by a group of men at a gig and taken in a car at gunpoint and sent into this giant room in one of the hotels, and they said, go over and play piano, which he promptly did. It turned out he was the surprise guest Al Capone's birthday party. And he was actually very relieved that he wasn't going to die and just had to play piano. You can imagine how that would have gone. So this is Ain't Misbehavin'. It's actually arranged by Luther Henderson, who was the staff arranger for the Canadian Brass for many years.
I just wanted to tell you, especially for those of you here in the audience today, and again, thank you all for those of you who are online, but it is so nice to get out and play for actual people again and sit on an actual stage with my friends and get to do this. So we're very excited that the world is kind of coming back to a somewhat bit of a normal place. Of course, stay careful, but enjoy music making whenever you can. The next piece we're going to do is by composer Anthony DiLorenzo, a young composer originally from Massachusetts. Actually is making his way in the world as a film trailer composer. You've actually heard some of his stuff. He's done trailers for Toy Story 4, League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, lots of movies. And if you're not familiar with the industry, composers are always hired to write music for film. But when the trailers come out for those films, the music is never done for those things, because the last thing that goes into a film is the music. And so while the composers are whiling away building the music for these films, they hire other composers to write trailer music. Quite typically, it's not the music that you're going to hear in the film. So there's a lot of work for that. Actually, Alice Gomez, who you heard in the first half of the show, she actually also does some work for background film and trailer music. So Anthony DiLorenzo does that as well. He plays in a great brass quintet called the Center City Brass Quintet, so he gets to try out a lot of his music with them. And this piece was written for the Center City Brass. This is called Fire Dance. This is a real hold on to the seat of your pants, because we're going to burn through this one. It's about 3 minutes, if you can play it fast enough. So ours will be about 3 minutes and 20 seconds, I think, because, right, safety first, I think, is the way we want to handle it. And remember, speed kills. So we're going to play Fire Dance for you. Hope you enjoy this by Anthony DiLorenzo.
Thank you.
Thank you again for coming tonight, and thank you for all of you that are online watching. We appreciate it. We appreciate live music again, and in the fall, I'm sure we're going to have much more of it. For all the students here and watching, we appreciate your resilience and your persistence, and it will pay off. We will come back to something much more normal in the fall and be able to perform with each other again, which I think, without social distancing, which will be a welcome relief for all. We're going to close tonight's program with a classic Duke Ellington composition. It don't mean a thing if it